So, a big thing, a big reality for me is that this isn't up to me. So it really does come down to what exactly are you thinking? It's just, for me, it's a big deal, you know? I've always seen myself being a parent. Would you want to be a parent?
It's not that I don't want kids. I just want to make sure I have my life together first. I don't want kids, you know, while I'm still trying to figure stuff out. I mean, I just got to America, so I have a whole life to kind of sort out right now. So, like, taking care of someone else is, like, the last thing on my mind. I need to make sure, you know, I start my life here. I mean, like...
I just don't know what I would do with my future if I never have a family. Like, I don't know what would we do. It just be me and you in the mountains.
But again, I never said that. You didn't ask me anything. You walked away. The problem is pregnancy. It's not I'm against families. It's pregnancy. And you have not asked me... You still haven't even asked me one question about
that. Well, I'm trying to figure out what you're trying to say.
If someone you loved have health problems, you'd ask them, is it okay? What's wrong? What happened? You won't just be like, okay, whatever. I don't really care about that. Let's get to what I want, which is
tell me what you're afraid of about being pregnant.
Obviously, for me, it's like... I told you, obviously, when I was 15, I had the cyst, and that was on my ovary, so I had surgery to remove it. I kind of just accepted the fact that, like, I don't want to be pregnant after that health scare, because, like, I could have died if they didn't remove that, you know? And it was like, or if I would have not had it taken out, then I wouldn't have been able to have kids. So it's kind of, that scare was enough for me to be like, okay, like, I can't carry a child, so I guess I'm not going to be a mom. It's not something that's been an easy journey for me, and it's kind of still, even now, it causes me problems. So it's like, I think with pregnancy, I just know that I wouldn't be okay if I had that. That's the reason I don't want to get pregnant, not just because, oh, I just don't care to be a mom.
On a certain level, it's like, I don't want to walk you all the way into a life that you don't really, you never saw for yourself, and then, you know, you end up not enjoying or wanting or resenting me for it. And I don't want to all just feel like it's all me making you do things you don't want to do. It's like, I also care about what you want.
It's not necessarily kids. It's like, you know, I like kids. That's not the problem. The concern is the actual, like, pregnancy. I'm willing to obviously work with you on a solution for it, but there's two options, adoption or surrogacy. So would you consider either of them, or?
I mean, I would like to raise little me's, so surrogacy sounds like the route that I'm more partial to.
I think the surrogacy thing, like, I'd be okay with it.
I just need you to really search your soul to understand what you really, really, really want, regardless of what I want. Regardless of what I want.
I want to be with you.
Now that we've talked about it, it sounds like at the end of the day, she would want to be a mom. She just doesn't want to have children, which I understand that. So if we could explore the other options, then I feel like me and Sophie could move forward with having a family. So I think we'll be okay, as long as that's really what she's really what she wants.
Are you gonna wear something like super classy or medium? Or
super classy or medium classy?
What are you wearing?
Probably like khakis and a blue shirt.
Mm-hmm. In England, I do go to the club a lot more regularly, because he never wants to go to the club, ever. He hates the club.
When you're single, you want to go out more and party more, but, you know, now that I have got a woman, I'm not really thinking about going out to the club, and plus I feel like there's potential for more problems. Like, if I go to the club and some girl's hitting on me, then I might end up in trouble, whereas if I would have just stayed at home and hung out with you, then that's not gonna happen.
I mean, you can stay out of trouble just having fun with me. I don't think I've been to, like, an actual club in LA even, so it'd be cool to, like, see.
I've only been to, like, one or two clubs in LA.
Really?
Yeah, because they're mad expensive. It's like $100 to get in some places.
When was the last time you've been to a club?
A few years ago with Tarai.
Yeah, he's coming, isn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Why are you making faces?
I don't know. I just feel like it's a bit awkward. I'm definitely not looking forward to seeing Rob's friend Tarai, just because he has been in Rob's ear a bit about me.
She popped up on Tarai's phone on a dating app, and since then he's been on the fence about what is this person someone he wants his friend to be with.
It was never a dating app. I was on the girl side of a friend's app. I invited Soraya, if that's cool, to the club. Because like, you're going to be with Tarai. Tarai's coming. So it's like, I don't want it to be you, Tarai, and me. That's super awkward. I met Soraya at the exact same time frame as when Tarai saw me on the app. But for me to have met Soraya, she was on the friend side. She wouldn't have shown up if I was on the date side. So I feel like that's proof of I made a whole friend on the same app at the same time. So I feel like I don't really need to prove anything else. That's as much proof as I can give, really. That's too much.
I mean, that's kind of like a going like salsa dance or something.
Yeah.
It'll take you an hour to get ready, right?
You as well. Don't wait for me.
What do you mean? You got like
an
hour and a half
of
work.
You've got a yellow shirt on.
Man, it's going to take me 10 minutes to get ready.
Sophie 100% takes longer to get ready to go out. It's kind of like I should do something else to not suffer while I wait. Like watch a movie. And then the last 30 minutes of the movie, 30 minutes before we leave, then I'll get ready to go out.
You want me to look good or not?
You look amazing all the time. So I don't need to wait 2 hours. Do I look good?
Yeah.
It takes me 30 minutes.
LA nightlife, here we go. Here we are.
Go on, girl.
I'm going.
Finally.
You know he gonna talk about us being late.
Come on, man.
What's up?
How you doing?
Hi.
Hey, what's up, Sophie?
Nice to see you.
Good to see you finally. It's been forever.
Yeah, eventually she was gonna have to see you.
Why you been hiding? What you scared of? I'm super protective over Rob, so I just want to make sure that the people that are coming into his life are doing it for the right reasons. I think she realizes Rob has a soft spot for her, so she might be playing that to her advantage or might be, you know, playing Rob a little bit. I don't know, who knows, but I'm gonna definitely pick her brain. You meet any new friends, Sophie, while you're out here?
Not really.
Oh, no, not yet?
No.
You got one friend coming though, right?
One friend?
Yeah, no. My friend Soraya is coming.
Oh, where'd you meet that friend?
I met her like when I came here like the first time.
Okay.
I just met her on like a friend's dating app.
Oh,
that's where I meet all my friends.
That's what we call them now. Friends date naps?
Yeah.
I didn't know they made those.
Yeah.
I thought they were just date naps.
Soraya's coming.
Oh, where'd you meet that friend?
Okay. I just met her on like a friend's dating app.
If you're on a dating app and you're meeting other girls, I would think that you're into girls or something like that. I think she's been avoiding all the tough questions. She doesn't want to answer any of the questions that I have for her. In my experience with dating apps, is you're on there to date, you know, I don't know too much about making friends. I don't know if that's what
you're
calling.
I mean, there's like a best friend mode.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You met Soraya on that same app, right?
I met her on the app, and she was on the friend side
So when I meet her, she's going to say, hey, I met her on this date app, right?
Okay,
all right. My fault, I'm just saying. I feel like I'm getting the truth, but you never know. I mean, women are capable of anything. You know, take it from me, I know from personal experience. I don't want to put my personal experience onto Rob's situation, but I really don't know. I can't tell. I can't call it right now. I don't know what's going on.
Ain't that your girl over there?
Oh my gosh, so good to see you.
Oh my God, you too.
You're so
nice.
Blonde.
So are you.
My name is Soraya. I've known Sophie for about 2 years. She's great, love her. Whenever she comes into town, of course, we like to go have a good time. So I'm excited.
Tarai.
Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Tarai.
Hi, good to see you.
My God, you're so buff. Relax over here. Relax.
You're
getting his head even bigger.
I know, I gotta say.
I'm so ready for a drink. That's what I said.
Okay, let's get in line then. Come on.
Okay.
Excuse us.
That's
the shot? Yeah. Why is it so big?
To love, to friends, to a great night, and let's just enjoy ourselves.
Cheers to that.
Oh, my God.
We got this, man. Perfect. Yeah.
Confirm something for me. You met her on the friends side of the app?
Yeah.
Like, there's a friends and then there's a dating side. You met her on the dating, on the friend side.
On the friend side.
So you're not into girls?
No.
Okay. I just want to make sure.
That was a super awkward moment because Soraya doesn't know, Tari doesn't know, Rob doesn't know that I'm bi. No, we were looking for friends.
Right,
definitely. Friendship. We made a great friendship.
We've had a great friendship.
It's like, I'm going to lie because I'm not going to come out right now in front of three people. But yeah, no, I was on the app for friends, though. I wasn't on it for women also at that time, yeah.
I guess the whole friend dating app thing was real.
She's the proof. She is the proof.
This is the proof right here. I apologize. I was wrong.
See, I told you. That same app that I met Soraya on, I'm still on that app to make friends because I don't know anyone out here. And there's bi women on the friend side. Like, you can be bi and still, or gay even, and look for friends. So it's like, I do have the option, I guess, of asking them. Well, as long as I don't do anything to disrespect them, it's like, I feel like I should be allowed to do that.
We met when? What year was it?
2019.
Yeah. Oh my God, we've been dating for 2 years.
I know.
I told you, you gotta watch out. You gotta watch out.
But I do know that, like, I probably should tell Rob soon that I'm bisexual. I've just been putting it off for a bit because lately we've been arguing so much. But I think I should probably tell him soon. I just wanted to get away from, like, Rob and his house and his dog and his whole life, basically. So I've just come here to, like, get away from him and have some space.
What would cause you to need, literally, to get out of his apartment?
Basically what happened was I had a dream the night before, right, that Rob online cheated on me. So the next day, I just checked his phone. I never check his phone, but I was like, let me just check because I had a dream about it. I went on his Instagram, didn't find anything, and then I went on this one app, and, like, basically he's been getting, like, disgusting videos from other women and, like, asking for just, like, nudes, and, like, the videos are disgusting and he's, like, entertaining it. And I was just like, I found the videos, and then I was just like, you need to drop me off. I don't even want to talk to you. Like, I just left. I just had to leave. I was packing my stuff. He was trying to stop me. Like, I just took what I could and I left. I threw the ring. I didn't even have the ring anymore. I threw the ring. So yeah, right now,
you've hurt me again, bro.
I've been trying to be perfect, but I'm not perfect, man. I'm not. Like, I'm not perfect, but I'm definitely not trying to you with nobody else but you. I just want you. I want you in my life. I don't want nobody else.
Baby. The messages. I saw the messages, even the ones that you didn't save. I've seen them, bro. So I don't care what you keep saying. It doesn't mean anything to me. You're just a liar.
No wonder he never asked me for sexual videos. He's getting them from, like, I don't know how many girls. It's just a lot, and he's disgusting right now, and I just don't want to be, like, anywhere near him. No one wants to see their partner, you know, get turned on for anyone other than them. If you're getting pictures from another person that's not your partner and jacking off to them and watching all this disgusting stuff and requesting videos and having a fun time with someone other than your partner, that's cheating. Some people might look at it as not, but to me, that's disrespectful and it's hurtful. So for me, I consider it cheating.
He did this before, and I nearly broke up with him because it was like just after a year, I think after we'd been dated, he did the same thing, and he was like banking off back to her. Sorry, this is really explicit, but like he was doing inappropriate stuff. The girls doing inappropriate stuff, and it's like I said, you can't hurt me like this again. If you do this, I'm leaving. So he knew what he was doing. I'm literally shaking talking about it. My face is getting really hot. If I was back in England, I would have left this guy. He would have been history. Goodbye. I would have gone to my mum's or my friends. See you never. Where am I supposed to go? I'm in this house I've rented by myself because I have no friends to go. I have no family member to go. I have no, at least a job, staff, friends. I don't have anything. I don't even have a car. So it's like, I don't have anywhere to go. I don't know what I'm supposed to do now. And obviously, if I don't marry him, I have to go home. So I've given up everything for nothing. I don't want to throw away my whole life that I've been trying to build to be in LA with Rob. It's like, I have to give up that. I have to give up that dream. And he just gets to live the same life with no consequences. He doesn't have to leave. He just gets to do what he's doing. It's definitely very hard. Sorry, one second. When I don't have anyone out here, obviously, and it's just me, and it's like, I just feel very trapped and very alone, and what he's done to me, it's like I'm hurt, but at the same time, it's like, I don't have anywhere to go, and I don't really know what I'm supposed to do, and I just feel very, it's a very lonely feeling, and it's very difficult to process, and my mind's just trying to, like, block the pain, but it is a bit difficult. I'm just really trying not to think about it. But it's hard. That's the thing, it's like, it's not even that he's hurt me. It's that I don't, what am I supposed to do now?